swear I heard him.
Please help me.
He's right there.
Tick-tock.
Still.
Tick-tock.
Lest he take you too.
Tick-tock. Tick-tock. Tick-tock.
Please help me.
Thank you. I took the blame for what happened. It pains me still, and surely it would be a stain upon my soul until the day I die, and I'm fully expecting to be turned away from heaven on account of what I did. Though I've said to God how truly sorry I am, time and time again, I don't feel forgiven, not one bit. I guess he has good reason to be angry. Poor Min Min. She was just a silly child with no business playing around the woodpile. She didn't know what she was doing. And for certain, Miss Rose was encouraging her foolishness more than she should have been. Bringing me flowers. Shh. What's a man to do with flowers?
Do you really want to open that door? Tink, tock, tink, tock. What's in the box? In sea wind, sea spider crawled up the water spout. Down came the rain and washed the spider out.
Help me, for he holds me tighter than the others.
Many mean well, but alas, cannot always be trusted, for this pitiless blackness casts strange shadows on the soul.
Grim Haven, it was not my choice, and this was not the course I will set for my life. Nor the story I would have written had I held a pen. But alas, I'm not the writer, merely the final chapter of a tale written generations before, of famine, fishermen, navigators, gold diggers and debt. A story which ends with myself, Edvard, 15 years old and far from my Norwegian homeland, penniless and stranded, like a sea trout in a net, entangled by a force of which I have no understanding. For the one who casts this net reeks of horror, of fear, and sinks my stomach to the floor whenever I hear his approach. It is like being in a hypnotist trance, for I can think of no happy thoughts to buoy my spirit, but am overcome by the ceaseless ticking of his timepieces. Pocket watches, of all descriptions. In this place, between the realms of darkness, there is no learning, no beauty, no art, except whatever thoughts and images I can conjure in my mind. For art has always been my release. It seems my yearning for peace and quiet within the orphanage walls, so that I may sit and draw unhindered, was duly noted by God, with no mean measure of annoyance. So, in his wisdom, he placed me here, within the nothing world. Perhaps this is penance. Perhaps I am paying for the sins of my forebears. For there are Vikings in my line, and through lineage, blood on my hands. Am I a sacrificial child, upon whose shoulders God has placed the sins of the fathers? I feel as one does on a summer's day, when as a small child, one would stand in the center.